Hey, what's up everybody, and welcome to Two Tall Toby's Tutorials, where today we're going to take a look at this coil mount model. A lot of people looked at this in the practice models challenge and were asking me down in the comments how I would model this, and would I model this with sheet metal? And the answer is no, I would not model this with sheet metal. It's true that you can do it if you created an edge flange coming off of a curve, but for me personally, once I created the pattern of those three little mounting tabs on the bottom, I couldn't get the thing to flatten. So don't do it as sheet metal. Create that extra tab using a revolve. Let's get into the software and see how it's done. And if you enjoy this type of a video, be sure to like, be sure to subscribe, and be sure to let me know what you thought about the video down in the comments. All right, so the challenge we're going to look at today is called 23-11-01 Coil Mount. This comes from the Two Tall Toby Practice Models playlist. And as always, in these practice models, I challenge you to run up against the clock. So let me hit play on this video, and we will get the clock going here. And let's start out with a basic game plan. How are we going to approach this model? And I know the model is kind of shown as though it is sheet metal. It's got uniform wall thickness. It's got the same bend radius in each location. But sometimes when models have curves that are bent along curves, you're better off just modeling it as a solid rather than trying to fight with the sheet metal functionality and try to get the sheet metal to do something that it's not really that good at doing. Doing a bend along a curve usually doesn't work that well in SolidWorks. So when I get a model like this, I'm gonna notice that this little flange that's sticking down on the bottom here, this little flange here, that it's bending along a curve. And so instead of fighting with sheet metal, I'm probably just gonna opt to do that using solid features. And in this case, I'm gonna do that using a revolve. So we always wanna look at the model. We always kinda wanna think about how we're gonna build this model. It is a thin-walled feature, so I could probably start out by creating a sketch like this, creating that as kind of like a thin walled feature and extruding it. And then when it comes to creating the tab, I could, you know, try to extrude the tab and create this blend here, but I think I'm probably better off doing a revolve. So creating a shape like this and revolving it about a center line. And then maybe I'll just kind of oversize that feature and go back in from this top view and create like a slot shape to cut away that excess material. So once I create that shape, the revolve, and then the cutaway, I should have a nice shape that I can do a circular pattern with to pattern that tab into the additional locations. And then all that's left is maybe adding a couple of final features, adding like the little fillets here on the backside, adding this slot, and then I can finish up by adding this notch, which only exists on the one side. So I know that took almost 2 minutes just to kind of go through and come up with a game plan, but I always encourage my students, before you get started actually doing the CAD, come up with a game plan, have a basic idea of what features you're going to be creating, and it will save you time in the long run, and it's also just a really good exercise to do every time you get a new challenge. So always start out by coming up with a game plan. Now let's get into the software and actually start creating this model. So I'm going to work from my templates here. I have some pre-cooked templates, and one of those is the plain carbon steel in millimeters, which is the units and the material we're working with here today. And since I already have a game plan, I know right where I'm going to start with this thing. I'm going to start out by creating a sketch here. That sketch is going to have a diameter of 55 millimeters. And then I'm going to create a rectangle, and I'm going to use the tab key here to jump to the second dimension on the rectangle and then give that a dimension of 23 millimeters. And that way I can just kind of drag that point right onto the circle. There we go. And then I can finish off here by dimensioning up to this point here. And that's going to be a dimension at, what do we got here? 42 millimeters. And now I am going to fill it off these corners in the sketch rather than doing it at the feature level. So to make that a little easier, I'm just going to kind of trim this up. Whoops, I lost my 42 millimeters there. Maybe I should have trimmed first. And then I'll take these 2 points and make them horizontal. And I'll take these 2 points and make them horizontal. And now I'm ready to add my sketch fillet. And that sketch fillet is going to be at 5 millimeters plus 3 millimeters for the wall thickness, since this is going to be the inside of the perimeter. And we'll add that sketch fillet there. There we go. That looks excellent. And I think we're ready to take that 2D sketch and turn it into a 3D model. So we jump into the extrude command. This is going to go up to a height of 28 millimeters. And we're going to use a thin feature option here. That thin feature option is going to be 3 millimeters. And it's going to go the opposite way, since my dimensions here, my 55 and my 23, are going to the inner dimensions of that print. So we hit the green check mark. There we go. That creates our first feature. So far, so good. I think everything's looking pretty good here so far. Let's go on to our second feature, which is going to be that revolved feature. So I'm going to go to the right plane, begin a sketch, orient my view. Now, I could do this with a thin feature as well, meaning I could just create the sketch geometry here. So this time it's going to be an inside radius of 5, and we're going to have a line coming off of there, and that's going to be tangent. And at this point, I could kind of jump into my revolve with that thin geometry, but I think it's going to be a little easier to manage if I just do an offset entities here at the sketch level, and then do the revolve using a regular solid revolve. So I'm going to offset that at 3 millimeters. I'm going to say I do want to utilize the cap ends option, and I want to cap those ends with lines. And that way, as soon as I'm done doing that offset, I get a line here and a line here. Very nice feature in the offset entities command in SolidWorks. And so now this is going to go down to a depth of 38 millimeters. And then as far as this location here, it just kind of needs to be out in space, you know, somewhere beyond that 90 millimeters plus radius 10. So at least 100 millimeters from the center line. Maybe I'll make it a little bit oversized just to be safe. So I'll make that like, say 120 over 2 from that center line. That should be enough to make sure that I've got enough room for that 45 radius and the 10 millimeter radius on top of that. So let's go in here and turn that into a revolve. Features revolve. I only have one center line. So when I choose feature revolve, SolidWorks automatically picks up on that center line. We'll make that 120 degrees and we'll say that we want that to be a mid-plane revolve. So there we go. That gives us that nice mid-plane revolve. Now we need to remove that excess material. So I'm going to pick this face here, begin a sketch, orient my view, and I'm going to create that diameter 90 or radius 45 that I mentioned a moment ago. So diameter 90 there. Let's make that for construction. And I think I'm just going to use a regular straight slot here. So I'll just start at the origin and go right down to that quadrant point. And then this slot is going to have a radius of 10 millimeters. And really, at this point, if I wanted to, I could include the interior slot sketch as well. I think I'll do it as a separate feature just because I kind of tend to prefer to break up my features, but I probably could just include that right in this sketch. But okay, what I'll do is I'll do that as a separate feature. I'll go into the extrude cut command. This is going to go in this direction. It's going to go through all, and then I'm going to use this option here, flip side to cut. So instead of cutting what's interior to that sketch geometry, I'm going to cut the exterior of that sketch geometry. And oh yeah, that is beautiful. That is exactly what we were hoping for there. So now I'll do the same thing here, begin a sketch, orient my view, create a slotted sketch here. This is going to use the same center point as that larger slot that I had created a moment ago. This one is going to have a 8 millimeter wide slot here. So 8 millimeters and then 4 millimeters center to center on that one. 4 millimeters center to center, and we'll go extrude cut, right mouse button, through all, right mouse button. That gives us that feature there. And now we're ready to take those two features, really those three features, the revolve, cut extrude one, cut extrude two, and turn them into a circular pattern. So we choose circular pattern. I'll just choose this cylindrical face here. And that looks pretty good, but let's see what happens when I hit the check mark. Doesn't look so good there, right? So the reason why is because that cut extrude through all flip side to cut is probably cutting away the additional instances. And so instead of solving with that dynamic kind of like end condition where it's going through all the outside, I'm just going to say make a geometry pattern, which means make an exact copy of the original geometry. Don't worry about the dynamic end conditions. So when I hit the check mark here, oh yeah, that's what we wanted. Geometry pattern for the win in that spot. So now let's get over to kind of the side view here and let's jump in and create some fillets. This is going to be a standard fillet with a radius of 7 millimeters. And then this is a little trick that I learned from watching Ivan in the tournament. I can do a window select here on this corner, window select here and a window select here on this corner. And that way I'm only picking those edges to be filleted. And you can see here when I hit the check mark, boom, there is that 7 millimeter fillet. So kind of a cool little shortcut you can use when you have multiple edges that are all right right in line with one another. All right, I'm going to go here. I'm going to begin another sketch. This is going to be another slot. It is centered here. It's defined as being 7 millimeters in, 7 millimeters in, but I'm just going to assume that they want it to be centered there. And I'm going to say that this slot has a width here of 5 millimeters, and this slot has a center-to-center distance of 10 millimeters. S key, extrude cut, and we're going to run that thing through all. Yes, this part is coming together nicely. And now for our final feature, we're going to begin a new sketch on this face here. And we're going to take this edge and do a convert entities. And then we're going to create a couple of lines. So we'll make a line here that goes from the origin to that point or to that arc. A line here that goes from the origin at that arc. And then we're just going to trim those off. So we just kind of have like a slice of pizza here. And now we're going to create a dimension from this line. And when we click the end point of this line, this brings up the magic dimension angle command, the dimension angle handle. And so then we can make that at 15 millimeters without, or 15 degrees without having to create an additional construction line. And so we can pick these two edges here, these two lines here, make them at 45 degrees. And now we're ready to take that, turn it into a 10 millimeter deep cut extrude. And there we go. We do the final spin. We kind of look at the print. We look at our model. We say, does it look right? Does it look like it's matched up? Looks pretty good to me. And so now we can go to the evaluate command in SolidWorks. We can choose the mass properties command. And we can see that we are coming up with a mass of 149 grams. So now let's go back to our practice models video. Let's pause the video, 10 minutes and 15 seconds, and let's go all the way to the end of that video where we see the answer, and the answer is 149 grams. So we did it, we got it correct, and now I could go down into the comments and I can say, and there we go. We can add that comment, then everybody can see how fast we did it. Let me know down in the comments if you have any questions for me, if you did it a different way, and if you have any suggestions for any upcoming video tutorials, any requests, let me know that as well. Be sure to like, be sure to subscribe, and be sure to come back for the next Too Tall Toby video.